Hey Lovebugs, it's Roslynn back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing blessed, and I'm doing blessed and highly favored, and definitely hope the same for you. And if this is your first time coming to my channel, much love to you, and welcome into my returning subs, my growing, extended, beautiful family. Just thank you for being you, heading towards the path that you were meant to be on, shining your light and being your true self. And with that being said, much love to all. Namaste, love and blessings, love and light, and many blessings are definitely coming your way. And if you have been watching my videos for a while and have not already, what are you waiting for? Like and subscribe, even hit that notification bell so you know when I'm about to upload my next video. And if you are comfortable enough, please go ahead and drop me a line or two. I would love a chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me, even if it's about your the positive feedback of the content of my video, or you just up tell me about your empathic gift and how it impacted your life heading towards a positive direction. And if you feel like the video has just gave you good vibes or just been very informative to you to where you want to share it with other people, go ahead and do so. And while you're at it, give me a thumbs up, like, and even share on your social media favorites. And thank you once again for showing the channel and my videos love and support. And I hope you're able to resonate with the content of my video. And today, the meditation I'm listening to is meditation music for positive energy, clearing subconscious negativity, and relaxing mind and body. And I'll post that link in the description box below. And y'all want to apologize. I keep on forgetting to say that on my video, and it's like my third video I'm doing. But I want to apologize for not giving y'all a heads up video to let y'all know I was just taking a break. But when my vibes are that low, when I'm just that drained, I don't want to, you know, impose on nobody's life by bringing that daggone dead weight, dead energy, low energy to somebody's life. So I do apologize from now on. If y'all are not new to the channel, and y'all know every few days, you know, 4 or 5 days, I just, you know, need to go ahead and take a break just to recharge, you know, get more content up, knowing more things that I need to go ahead and address and talk about. So I do apologize. So I did miss y'all for that little 24 hours, but I needed to rest up and, you know, just take a break and do some me time and, you know, just recoup and reflect. So y'all, you know, I'm glad y'all were patient with me, and I appreciate that y'all still being here. But my video today is about Twin Flame 101. Heyokas, when people that were sent to break you, people that you were sent to break you. I don't know why I keep doing that. I keep seeing stuff in the corner of my eye, knowing there's nothing standing, you know, standing there. But, you know, I keep seeing stuff moving at the corner of my eye, and I'm the only one here. But, yeah, you know, when we have gone through so many things, I you know, when I've gone through situations, and I take that moment to meditate and reflect on, you know, everything I've been through in life, and, you know, how it has changed me, how it has made me put walls up, how it made me look at a lot of people when it comes to trust, how I've opened my life up to a certain extent. You know, I have really reflected on it, and it's just like when you have that time, you know, you've really gone through some things, and people have really did some, you know, got ungodly things to you, you know, and you try to find the reason, that you try to find the answers on the reason why these people have did these things to you. And it's just like from all the research that I've been doing on, you know, just by the gifts that we have, is just certain empaths, when we hit those categories on being multi-gifted, on being empath with a Heyoka empath, and then me being a twin flame, white witch, and indigo, INFJ, all these different things that are wrapped up into one, where the things I've experienced in life, you know, has really been dark, has really been hard. But when I think about the things that, you know, I have that power to hurt somebody, but what would I accomplish out of that? You know, I would have every reason to do that, but I cannot play God with somebody's life just because they decide to do that with mine. People tried to alter my life, lie about it, you know, but everything happens for a reason. It's just like, you know, and I know we hear that all the time, and it's just sometimes we don't understand the reasons of the life that we are dealt, you know. And it's just like you have to think, and I was thinking about this right before I did the video, and I was meditating, I started laughing to myself. You have to think, before this lifetime, you know, if you watch videos, you've done the research and know, you know, we have picked our own families. You know, a lot of people don't believe that, but we picked the lives that we decided to be put in, for us to learn off of the people that we have to encounter or connect with, from them learning off of us. And, you know, you had to be a bad mother shut your mouth for you to be, when you really going through some jacked up stuff with a lot of jacked up people, you know you had to be something, a force not to be reckoned with, for you to be able to pick something that you got through, that you are going through at the current time. You have to really look at life that way. You must have been somebody that cannot be touched. For you to say, you know what, this family look like they done went through some hell and high water and still seem like they're creating hell. Let me go ahead and put myself in the midst of this storm so I can go ahead and correct this, because this ain't right. You know, you keep continue to do this and you're put in the midst of that war, because you have to be able to solve that issue, solve the problem amongst other people as well as yourselves. Be able to look at things in that positive light of being that bigger and better person. Because it's just like when I've gone through things of, you know, being in a narcissistic relationship with, you know, a person I've been with for years. And then on top of that, finding something he was in common with my adopted father that I went through this with for years, because this is all I knew when it came to men. Is, you know, I didn't know anything good. I wasn't blessed to have my father in my life to show me what a man really supposed, how is a man supposed to treat a woman? How is he supposed to respect her? How is, you know, he's supposed to treat her as his queen, as she's supposed to treat him as her king? You know, I didn't have that pleasure in life. So I had to be able to go through all the bumps and bruises just to know, you know, through all the mishaps, to be able to get my strength to know, okay, you can't disrespect me like this, or I don't want to allow myself to be put in a predicament that makes me seem less than a person, or let me belittle myself, not put myself in a predicament for that, you know. And it's just like, you know, we had these people sent in our lives to, we had to get strength from. They had to learn something of a hard lesson. This is their karma on how they treated us. They give us that dirt. They give us that ish that we have went through. We had to go through those hell and high waters just to be able to know the things that we experienced and be able to have a story to tell off the lesson that we have gotten from this experience. So it's just like when I see the people that have did things to me and did wrong things, I used to hate them for that. I used to want to get retaliation. I wanted revenge, but this is my time for redemption. I don't have time for those things anymore. I don't have time for it because they're in their own personal hell. I've gotten to the point where my hate started turning into pity. Because when you see people that are going out their way to hurt you or finding ways that, you know, they can put their energy on trying to belittle a person just to make you feel bigger, that you have to feel bad for somebody like that, because it's just like you really don't have that confidence in yourself. You being the real true person that you could be, to apply yourself to be a positive person, you put it on how to bring somebody down, how to, you know, wreck somebody's life. You have to feel really bad for somebody like that, you know. And there's times that I used to be angry and I'm just like, oh, I want my family to go to jail. I want them to have, you know, I want this bad things to happen to them. And I said, you know what, I can't. Obviously this has been taught to them for them to be going through that. Nothing like that is like birthed to be that, you know, abomination like that to somebody's life, you know. They had to be taught something like that. They had to go through something similar themselves to be able to, you know, imprint on somebody's life like that to make them feel like, you know, they have some kind of mental illness. It's like me and my friend were discussing this the other day. You know, when we have went through things that later on life has instilled us to make us feel like we have these mental illnesses. We have bipolar, we have schizophrenia, we have, you know, agoraphobia. You have these fears of certain things because of traumatic things you have experienced in life that made you closed off from things that made you fear that. You know, because it was always told to me, you know, you know, what if you do things, why would you do things that you might end up being famous, and you don't want people to know those things. And, you know, my family used to always instill that in me, and I'm just like, why would I be famous? What, you know, what would make me so big to where people would know about me? And I never was putting two and two together, but it was like, why should I be ashamed of what I did? Because it's like, not like I'm doing them now. This is what brought me here, my past. Yeah, I've been to jail. I've shoplifted. Yeah, I wrote bad checks. You know, I've had my car repossessed. I've got evicted. But that, you know, those things have brought me here. It's brought me strength. You know, I can't be embarrassed about the things that I've been through, because that is not My situation is not the product of who I am now. And that's not a product. The things that you went through is not the product of who you are now. You are that person that survived over whatever that was sent to break you. You are that product to know that you survived this war, to know that you're lived to see a fight another one another day. So you have to really look at your life and know that you are blessed, that you were able to overcome things that were meant to break you, the people that were sent in your life to, you know, to imprint on you in a bad light, to knowing that you will be able to shine past all that. So when you see that, you'll know you'll be blessed and you'll be the best person you can ever be. So I hope you're able to resonate with the content of this video. And I hope you send out as much love and light and positivity as you possibly can. Know that you are blessed, truly favored, highly loved, and knowing there is always somebody out there praying for your better days. And I'm sending much love, infinite abundance towards your way, healing vibes, uplifting vibes, comforting vibes, and loving vibes, especially if you truly need them. And, you know, give me a thumbs up, like, and even share on your social media favorites. Give me a thumbs up. And like and subscribe, hit that notification bell, drop me a line. I love a chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me. Or, you know. And that's it pretty much. Oh, let me get my post notification shout out. Post notification shout out. Who am I giving my shout outs to today? Indigo Rankin, much love to you, fam. I hope you're having a blessed week and prosperous week. And I hope you have a safe, blessed weekend, and I will see y'all in my next video. Peace and be wild.